A very good morning and good evening to all our esteemed participants once again. I'm personally super excited to be hosting all of you in this one-of-its-kind forum today. So 2020 was an action-packed year for automation, right? Despite all the COVID setbacks. In fact, COVID propelled a never-seen-before enterprise demand for automation. We also saw multiple high-profile acquisitions and a continued inflow of VC investments. While 2020 was a great year for hyper-intelligent automation, or HIA, we expect the momentum not only to continue, but also to amplify many folds as we enter 2021. We at Zinnov have been at the heart of this HIA-led transformation, and we've been talking to both the demand side and the supply side ecosystem. Since the beginning of this year, Zinnov has donned the hat of this popular Marvel Comics character, Doctor Strange. And using our crystal ball, we have laid down the top 10 trends for the year ahead. And to make things interesting, we have overlaid the HIA concept and the trends along the Marvel Avengers theme. So I'll walk you through some of these trends and simultaneously, as Praveen mentioned, we would have a live poll. So kindly provide your inputs there. And we'll quickly get started. So hyper-intelligent automation has evolved similar to Avengers, this combination of superheroes who individually are powerful, but put together can achieve even greater outcomes. In this corollary, we see HI rampantly moving beyond RPA and towards a convergence of multiple complementary technology areas, such as process discovery, intelligent document processing, IBPMS, low-code, no-code, and even API integration, right? With the final being AIML, which cuts across all technologies and in fact stitches all the other technology areas. Interestingly, RPA as a standalone technology is expected to phase out, and it is this confluence of technology areas, the Avengers ensemble of technologies, which would take the baton forward. Taking the HI trend forward, the second trend is around orchestration. Enterprises have evolved in their automation journeys and are no longer willing to lock themselves in with a single vendor. They demand more flexibility and are looking to work with multiple vendors based on the complexity of use cases catered to. As per our analysis, almost one third of the Fortune 250 enterprises are already working with two or more automation vendors. Consequently, we see that even platforms have realized that they cannot win this automation race on their own. And hence, there is a great push towards working in a co-opetition model and elevating their positioning as an orchestration platform. So low-code, no-code platforms have been the latest addition to HIA, much similar to Black Panther being added to the Avengers universe. Platforms such as Appian, Microsoft, and even Nintex have all made acquisitions recently to acquire RPA capabilities. These platforms came in with the promise of simplifying application development and making it as much as 10 times faster to build new apps, targeting both professional developers and citizen developers. These platforms enable workflow automation scenarios while completely eliminating the need for deploying RPA or bots. And if in case RPA is required, this can be done by partnerships or native RPA capabilities downstream. Hence, low-code, no-code tech has emerged almost as a threat to RPA bots. And even in terms of market size, low-code, no-code represents a bigger opportunity as compared to RPA or even the HI scheme of things. The next trend pertains to mainframes. Mainframes continue to remain the backbones of the IT architecture, with more than 80% of the global enterprise data still residing on mainframes. However, the one challenge that still plagues mainframes is how to unlock the data housed in these mainframes and integrate them with newer applications and architectures. This is where RPA came in as a band-aid solution to help integrate with these legacy systems, be it using mainframe emulators in order to access mainframes using screen scraping, or leveraging web services such as REST or SOAP services. While automation or RPA has provided one way to access mainframe data, it is becoming abundantly clear that the way ahead is clearly IT modernization, which has been identified as the top priority by majority of the senior IT leaders. In addition, there's been an increased focus on automation and AI on the mainframe, and this trend of mainframe modernization and then looking at automation opportunities is expected to amplify over the next 12 months. Typically, enterprises target the low-hanging fruits of automation to kickstart their journeys and show quick wins. These are generally identified using manual techniques such as crowdsourcing, internal workshops, hackathons, etc. We estimate that a majority of these enterprises will run out of these low-hanging fruits and look towards more scientific techniques such as process mining and task mining. 2021 will be the year of process discovery and will emerge as the Iron Man of automation. And this space is expected to grow, you know, massively at more than 70% CAGR and will exceed $3 billion in market size in the next 5 years. The first wave of growth within RPA and automation space was led by large enterprises. However, with large enterprises already getting saturated and with cloud gaining prominence in the wake of COVID-19, the space is today ripe for small and medium businesses or SMBs to take the baton and drive the next wave of growth within automation. These SMBs are also open to transition even their mission critical use cases or workloads on cloud. And hence, we estimate that SMBs' focus on automation through cloud deployment will amplify and double over the next 12 months. Similar to Moore's law, we are postulating an automation law where we are witnessing automation power and capabilities provided by platforms almost doubling every year. And AI is right at the heart of this transformation. While this started with RPA and simple automation targeting simple, low complexity use cases, we gradually saw AI making its way to tackle more complex use cases, be it in the document processing and OCR capabilities or discovery techniques such as process mining and task mining. AI has transformed the entire automation value chain end to end. And this is very similar to Nick Fury, who is, you know, the director at SHIELD and coordinates with and motivates all the superheroes to make sure they work well as a team. Platforms also showed immense focus on taking the inorganic routes to acquire newer capabilities throughout the past year. The most noteworthy ones included the tech giants such as Microsoft and IBM. In fact, yesterday we also learned about SAP acquiring Signavio, and we already spoke about the low-code, no-code application platforms making acquisitions. All of these acquisitions were focused on acquiring newer capabilities such as with an RPA or bolstering their existing capabilities. We expect that this year would see acquisitions to acquire vertical and horizontal depth, especially for specific use cases. For instance, there are tons of specialist platforms that focus on specific use cases, such as AP automation within F&A, such as AvidXchange, Use, Esker, et cetera. And these would be the prime targets for acquisition by the larger automation vendors in order to acquire deep capabilities. Linked to the consolidation trend, technology majors, such as Microsoft and IBM made their automation strategy abundantly clear in 2020 with flamboyant acquisitions. Others such as Google, ServiceNow, and Adobe are also already eyeing the automation space in a serious fashion. And these players have deep modern tech capabilities aligned to AI, ML, NLP, OCR, etc., which coupled with industry-leading partnerships ensures a very strong positioning across the entire hyper-intelligent automation framework. Hence, tech majors are poised to emerge as serious challenges to the incumbent vendors within automation in 2021, rapidly emerging as a ferocious Wolverine in this Marvel universe. And the last trend pertains to the much-hyped 5G phenomenon. As enterprises prepare to embrace the imminent 5G wave, it is imperative to identify the critical role automation stands to play across the deployment cycle of 5G, both pre-rollout and post-rollout. In order to make effective use of 5G-enabled applications across all connected devices, a complete overhaul of network and operations is required. The burden of getting it all right through DevOps can be effectively shared with automation, which would ensure a successful transition from 4G to 5G services. Similarly, automation will be pivotal in accessing and utilizing the data produced by 5G-enabled IoT devices. AI-led automation will allow analysis and interpretation of large volumes of data sets, which can in turn open new avenues for automation of industry-specific processes. So in summary, automation is clearly a fast-moving industry with things constantly evolving at a breakneck speed. These were the top trends which came out based on our detailed conversations within the ecosystem and with all of you. The objective today is to discuss and debate around some of these trends and lay down the top defining trends for 2021, which we jointly as a group feel would be the most pertinent. The broader objective is to form this cohesive group of senior leaders who define the single source of truth pertaining to the automation industry. And we intend to do these as a recurring biannual forum where we can revisit some of these trends and also course correct as required. So thanks again for listening in patiently. What we have next is an interactive open forum discussion aligned to a few key themes. So let me pass on the baton to you, Praveen, and request you to kickstart the next session.